Hello everyone, in this video we will cover concept of modernization of agriculture from unit 2 of rural livelihood and production systems. Basically, modernization of agriculture is a process of transforming agriculture from traditional labor based agriculture to technological based agriculture. Yes, the green revolution in India referred to a period when Indian agriculture was converted into a industrial system due to the adoption of modern method and technology, such as use of high yielding variety HYV seeds, tractor, irrigation facility, pesticides and fertilizer. You know, it was mainly found by M.S. Swaminathan. This was part of larger green revolution endeavors initiated by Norman, which leveraged agriculture research and technology to increase agriculture productivity in developing world. Under premiership of Congress leader Lal Bahadur Shastri, the Green Revolution within India commenced in 1965. That led to an increase in food grain production, especially in Punjab, Haryana and Uttar Pradesh. Major milestone in this undertaking were the development of high yielding variety of wheat and rust resistant strain of wheat. However, agricultural scientists like M.S. Swaminathan and social activists like Vandana Shiva are of the opinion that it caused greater long-term sociological and financial problem for the people of Punjab and Haryana. However, it proved to be a useful measure and was pioneer in helping the Indian government to independently produce necessary crop in their own, instead of depending on other countries and whose policy were often misguided by foreign nations to blackmail Indian to serve their own political purpose and get dominated by those nations. The next is farm management technology. Over the year, technology has proved to be extremely useful in the agriculture sector. Presently, farmers are able to grow crops in area where they were thought they could not grow, but this is only possible through agriculture biotechnology. There are various use of technology in agriculture, like first is farm machines. As you know, a challenge that farmer face nowadays is to satisfy the labor. This is an increased cost of labor, which called the better approach to ensure less cost of labor. The introduction of combined harvesters and planters simplify this process. Production and time are some of the important elements in agriculture. It's important, therefore, to plant early, harvest in time, as well as ensure that the yield is stored within the right time. The use of modern technology in agriculture ensure that farmers grow vast food variety that shorten the time possible. There are certain technology like GPS technology has also used in developing the autopilot spray and tractors that do not require any driver. Such technology is important in agriculture. It promotes better and more efficient farming practices. For example, like autopilot tractor and sprays are equipped with tracking system that eliminates human error and to save more fuels and equipments. Next is crop sensors. Efficient application of fertilizer and pesticides remain to a big challenge in agriculture, especially when it came to determine what fertilizer work best for different plant, when to apply, as well as what quality to apply. The use of crop sensor can make it easy for farmer to effectively apply fertilizer and pesticide just as much as crop need. Variable rate technology became useful in such case. Such technology give you the opportunity to sense your plants and feeling, subsequently help to reduce the probability of surface runoff. Crop sensor are designed in a manner that dictated the application machinery, the amount of the resources that given crop need at what particular time. The another is use of GPS in field documentations. GPS is becoming a common technology in agriculture. Let's take example Modern agriculture involves the use of GPS to document the status of farmland. Through the GPS, it is easy to determine the document the yield from a given farm. And not only that, record the application rate. Such technology are useful in that the farmer can rely on the collected and recorded data for reference when making any certain decisions. The recommended documentation technology in the yield map, which can be used to offer a summary of entire year activities, such map are highly useful as they can give a wider range of information about anything such as status of drainage system in your field, etc. Next is biotechnology. Biotechnology is also referred as genetic engineering and the process improving the genes of a given crop. In most cases, genetic engineering is carried out to increase the resistance of certain crop to farm input. Such the application of herbicides through biotechnology farm can plant on area that were otherwise considered dry or desert. Reduced farm input implies that the farmers as well as saves on the cost of farm resources. Some of the aspects that you should look in include how to apply organized fertilizer, irrigation, intensive agriculture, monoculture and application of other resources. However, in order to achieve all the goals, farmer need to understand the concept of farming and use of technology which will increase their yield. Organic farming. Basically, organic farming is a system that avoid or exclude use of synthetic inputs like pesticide, fertilizer, hormones, etc. and relying on technique like crop rotation, organic waste, farm manure and crop residue for plant and protection and nutrition utilization. For various reasons, organic farming has been adopted by Indian farmers. First category of organic farmer are those who are traditionally practicing the organic way of cultivation due to lack of availability of high intensive input resources. These farmers are following organic farming under the compulsion as they are located in no input or low input use zone. Second category of farmer include certified and uncertified farmer who recently adopted organic farming after understanding the ill effect of agriculture in terms of loss of soil fertility, food toxicity, increased input of cost, decreased market value. The third category of organic farm includes majority of certified farmer and enterprise which have emphasized on systematic adoption of organic cultivation in India to capture the emerging market opportunity and price. The entire data available on the organic agriculture today depend on third category of commercial farmer and enterprise who are attracting most attentions. Cooperative farming. Basically, cooperative farming refer to an organization in which each farmer member remain the owner of their land individually, but farming is done jointly and thereafter profit is distributed among the member farmer in the ratio of land owned by them. Thus, it will improve economics of scale, increase marketed share, increase credit worthiness. That this all about modernization is agriculture. Thank you.